have him in my pocket. Yeah? And guess what? And without even a piece of paper to write some note on it. In that days we didn't have money, but he's talking about his words again. Why, sir? Because he says, if you are leaving the home without a pen, then you are not willing to get knowledge. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allama bil qalam. Yeah? Ilm, I need a qalam. And if you haven't got a notepad in your pocket, it means you are not willing to take any notes. If you hear something useful. And alhamdulillah, I carried that habit with me. It became a habit, right? And if you want to make a habit, you have to enforce it first. So when I came to United Kingdom, Great Britain, I've been driving on the underground, on the buses, etc. And luckily, my dad taught me these things. So if I see, I used to read advertisements, and I don't know what they mean. And every time I come across a word that I don't know, I used to write it down. So when I get home, I get my dictionary, what's that mean? And I start writing different vocabularies. And I still haven't got enough vocabularies. Anyway, we start, inshallah. إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا. مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه. وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. واجعلنا في عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم رب جبرائيل وميكائيل وإسرافيل فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. اهدني لنختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. اللهم إني أعوذ بك أن أضل أو أضل أو أجل أو يجهل علي أو أذل أو أذل برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم نقني من الذنوب والخطايا كما نقيت الفروج من ذنب الدنس. والحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم. A question. Think about it logically now, applying logic. Do you wish that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his coming, was delayed until the nowadays of technology? Imagine Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is with us now. And instead of watching all these so-called scholars on Islam Destructing Channel, or sorry, Islam Channel, or any other channels, imagine that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is appearing on TV, on every channel. Imagine he's got his YouTube station, the volume YouTube, blah, 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 channel. Okay. And he's got his Twitter account and all that, etc. What do you think? Wouldn't that be better? That we get the knowledge straight from the source that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to get the knowledge from. Ignore every other knowledge and just get it from the main source. Would that not be better? Who was it better? Put your hand up. Just apply your logic. I put my hand up, it's better. Yeah. And I put two hands. Yeah. Imagine something else now. Imagine this technology that we have now. Allah revealed it 1400 years ago in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. Imagine now the companions are being filmed, you know, and preserved. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was filmed with wherever he goes, like all these celebrities. You know, these huge celebrities, wherever they go, they are filmed. He's going to his Mecca, but all these electronic films is available for us to access. So, and we see the hayat of the Sahaba. Many of us believe in the hayat of the Sahaba, the hayat of the companions. Would that be better? Logically, yes? No. Either way. No. Imagine printing books was available so easy nowadays. And imagine that a professor of Allah, he has written a book. And let's say he called it Fakhus Fakhu Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fakhu Siyam. Fakhu Qiyam. Imagine Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, لو كان نبيا بعدي لكان عمر. If there is to be a prophet after me, it would have been Umar. Umar al-Khattab alayhi salam radiallahu anhu, the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he once saw him in his dream. And he is narrating the dream that he saw about Umar to the companions. And he said, رأيت عمر في الجنة يجر ثوبه. You know, the thawb should be short. تدعى عن كل أبدع عن كل جان. But in Jannah, عمر ثوب was so long and he was dragging his thawb behind him. In his life, he thought was short, above the angel. So then the companions asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أُبَدُوا يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ What do you translate it to be? أَوْ فَمَا عَبَّرْتُهُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ What does that thing mean? He said, العلم, the knowledge. So here Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in so many different ways, he is talking about Umar, how much knowledge he has. In another hadith, he said, إِنَّهُ رَجْلٌ مَهْدِيٌ Umar is a man who is guided. In so many situations, Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he used to wish something to go in the Quran, and behold, ayah came down. Exactly what Allah says. And that's why Muhammad says to Allah said, إِنَّهُ رَجْلٌ مَهْدِيٌ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he revealed to him without wahi, of course, the hidayah, the guide. And that is why if we say, when we say, وَقُرْ رَبِّي سِدْنِي عِلْمًا And oh my Lord, my sustainer, increase me in knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can increase your knowledge in so many ways. And so much so that maybe you could read a little concise book and you understand that much knowledge of it. And you get other people, they may read volumes of books and they only get that much knowledge out of it. Yeah. And that's what Allah Azza wa Jalla وَعَلَّمَكَ وَلَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمَ كَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Qur'an is rahmah, knowledge is rahmah, knowledge is mercy for us. The more knowledge you have, you find this to be easier to deal. So not bad to our scenario. Allah azza wa jalla, he release knowledge as he will. Yeah? ومن آياته الحمير والبقال يتركبوها At the end of the ayah, he said, وَيَخْلُقُ مَا تَعْلَمُونَ Allah talk about the donkeys, the mule, yeah, the horses, that, so that we ride it, and we travel a distance with it. And then he said, and he will create things that you don't know yet. Things we see now, the airplanes. Yeah. The bicycle, the motorcycle, the car, the electric car, and all that. Do you think this is happening because mankind is clever? No. It only happened because Allah Azza wa Jalla decided now this knowledge it will be open for mankind. heavenly side is that electricity shall exist in his kingdom. Electricity was discovered in three different places, three different continents, simultaneously. It was discovered in England, in Germany, in America, and in China. At the same time, and people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided them to the knowledge of the electricity, they don't know what about it. I lived a time when to make a phone call to my family in Syria, before that I had to go and send a telegram, you know, and they said, my dad got these dots and so on, and they charge you for every letter. Technology moved, then you go to Trafalgar Square, to the post office in Trafalgar Square, and you book a call to Damascus. And then they give you a ticket, you pay it for so many minutes, and then when the call is ready, they call you, number so and so, go to booth number 5. So you go to booth number 5, and then they connect you. It moved on very quickly. I start making call from home, you know. Again, but you have to book a call. And then they call you from the extension. Oh, Mr. Osman, we're ready to connect you. Okay. So you have the phone and they connect you. It moved on, okay. I think 1985 or 86. Then I was making phone calls, dialing directly from the phone, directly to Syria. Now, look at it now. Now I can make a call from here. Not only a voice call, I can see them make a video conference. When British Telecom invented video conferencing, it was a big thing. Now we can only make video conferencing with our family. You know, on the move. What I'm saying is, look how the speed, actually, the speed of how knowledge progressed. And if I want to talk about how the speed is, ask our professor, our resident professor, Dr. Islam, who, you know, you can ask him about the obvious technology, how did it develop? It's so fast, unbelievable. Why? Because Allah wanted to reveal it. So now, back to the question. Why Allah Azza wa Jal did not delay the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to our time, the time of new technology? Anybody can give me an answer? The question is open to everybody. Why do you think Allah Azza wa Jal did not do what we think intellectually is best to do? And you know, okay, one answer, good answer, it's possible. Is it because we need to strive to get good knowledge? And if it's available at the finger, then we don't have that struggle to get it. So we'll get the same reward. That's clear. Sorry? The best of plan, yeah, but why did he plan it that way? Yes, Allah has the best of plan. Yes? No? Why did he plan that way? You got an answer? No? Okay. Any from your sisters you can answer if you want? Okay. The answer actually, yeah. Maybe to protect Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam from the rest of humanity. Again. Because they didn't make false films, etc. Possible as well. Okay. The answer actually is number one. The answer is number one. Okay. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, when we say ihdina sirat al-mustaqeem, sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wal-dhalin, you pray to Allah Azza wa Jalla to guide us to the straight path. Allah answered, alif lam mim dhalika al-kitab la rayba fihi hudan lil-muttaqeen. You want guidance? بس there it is in the book. ذلك الكتاب no doubt in it, فيه and in it there's guidance to those who want to acquire IT protection. Okay, how do you do that? What's the next item? Who are these متقين الذين يؤمنون where يؤمنون بي غيبي والظن that's the answer. The متقين are those who believe in the unseen, yeah, in the unknown. That is why Allah Azza wa Jalla would not delay the Prophet Muhammad until now, because now we have to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam without seeing him. We have to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and believe that the Quran that Muhammad came with to us from Jibreel, from Allah Azza wa Jalla came. We believe in it that has not changed. Ilmul Ghayb. This is the essence of it. We have to believe in an wiser, because العلم فتنة. العلم اتراجع. الله عز وجل سيد محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما بعثك أبتليك وأبتلي بك. I only send you so that to test you and test by you. How is that test? There is a test now. We get stuck in Islamic instructions, do and don't do. Sometimes doing and it doesn't make sense to us. So what do we do? Does it have to make sense to us? Or do we say سمعنا وأطعنا وغفرانك رب العالمين ونصير? We hear and we obey and we seek Allah's barakah. And we all return to Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's what's all about. It's all about actually we submit to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah is saying, وَيُسَلِّمُ تَسْلِيمًا. And when they submit with تسليم, say that's it. Yeah, Muhammad says, we believe it. Allah said, we believe it. Muhammad said, do, we do as much as we can. Muhammad said, don't do, we don't do at all. عليه الصلاة والسلام. ما أتيتكم به فأتوا منه ما استطعتم وما نهيتكم عنه فانتهوا. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said to translation of the Hadith, whatever I order you to do, then do of it as much as you can. Whatever I forbid from doing, then abstain from it completely. We just read the whole verse. ومن يشاقق الله ومن يشاقق رسوله بعد ما تبين له الهدى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين نوله ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساء مصيرا. And whoever steer away, split from the instruction of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he follows other ways other than the way of the believers, the believers that they believe in the unknown, in the way. Yeah, in the unseen. نوليه ما تولى وشكران him what he want to do, and then his way to Jahannam, to destruction, and the worst place to be. What are we talking about now? This is the test now. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, نحن أمة أمية لا نكتب ولا نحسب نصوم لرؤيته ونفطر لرؤيته. We are Ummah who is Ummiyah. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he described what is Ummiyah. And he said, we fast for seeing it. And we fast for seeing it. And we break fast for seeing it. نصوم لرؤيته ونفطر لرؤيته. We fast for seeing it, and we break fast for seeing it. What we're talking about? The crescent. Yeah? The crescent. What is the crescent? Is the crescent the moon? You think it's the moon? It's a crescent. No. The hilal is hilal. القمر is قمر. الله سبحانه وتعالى said the Quran قمر and moon is hilal. The hadith is hilal. Now, what's the difference between the two? When the hilal, the crescent appear constantly all the time and start developing, become bigger and bigger and bigger, it becomes a comer. Yeah? But when it appears like a thin piece, I show you, there you go. A very thin piece like that. Yeah? It appears so lovely. Okay? And then guess what? It disappears. It does not stay in the sky for more than a few minutes. Yeah? And that is called the new moon. Alhamdulillah, we have many sisters there. They all gave birth. Alhamdulillah, in our community. And you know the habit. When your sister have a baby, the baby is born. They show it to the mother. So look at the baby, oh, it's a girl, look at that beautiful girl, mashallah. A beautiful boy, etc. Then the mother will hug it a little bit, and then they will take it away from the mother, yeah, to go and clean it, you know, wash it, and put some nice clothes on. So the mother won't see it for a while. Okay? So she sees it for a bit, and then it will disappear, and then it comes again, nice and beautiful. Fresh. Just, I'm talking about similar. A newborn person, we Allah show it to us, not to everybody, and then it disappears. Now this is a test. This is a test. If Allah Azza wa Jalla want us to know whether the moon can appear or not appear, Allah would have delayed the knowledge until now. Allah does not ask us to go to study astrology or astronomy. What's the word astrology? Yeah. Or astrology, either. Yeah, yeah. To see the moon. Yeah. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he narrated, "Tara al-nasu al-hilala fa-akhbartu al-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inni ra'ituhu fa-sama wa-amara al-nasa bi-siyamihi." Listen to this hadith. Hadith from Abdullah ibn Umar. How old did he be? Abdullah ibn Umar. Anybody knows? He was a teenager. Just another man. Okay. And he said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Tara al-nas al-hilal," the people start looking for the crescent. Never said al-qamar. He said, "And I spotted it. I saw it. Then I went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I said, I saw the crescent." So the Prophet said, "No, maybe you haven't seen. Let's go to Regent's Park first. Let's go to Wimbledon. Common. We won't have to see it." What mean? So I will see it. Can you imagine? He's a prophet. And then he did not say to Ibn Umar, "No, I have not seen it, so what are you talking about?" Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam al-Mursaleen, the Imam of all the prophets and messengers of Allah Azza wa Jal, he did not seclude the crescent for himself. He did not say, "Oh, I don't see it." No, it's impossible for you to see it. He took the shahada, the witness of Ibn Umar, of Abdul Qadir ibn Umar, his son. Because why? Because he's a trustworthy. And only when shahada. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "I will fast," and he ordered people to start fasting. On one shahada, on one witnessing, one person trustworthy saw the hilal. What is that hilal? I don't know. Is it the moon? It's nothing to do with us. It's an ayah from Allah Azza wa Jalla. A sign from Allah Azza wa Jal. So why are we going to the kuffar, going to disbelievers and believe in their science and disbelieve in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? If you want to follow the scientists, hilal or qamar, do so.
وبن لاقي الجيل معه ليه بسألهم؟ ليه بسألهم؟ ليه بسأل محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام؟ Why brother and boss? You are following the disbelievers' science onto علم الغيب that we have to believe in the knowledge of the unseen. We don't have to understand what is the hilal. We don't need to. أمة أمية. لا نكتب ولا نحسب. We don't write. We don't calculate. We fast for seeing it, the hilal, and we stop fasting for seeing it, the hilal. Not the qamar of Tom, Dick, and Harry. Not the qamar that we have to drive 500 miles around to seek it. If you don't see it, it means that's it. It means other people are lying. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not say to him, I know you are lying because I have not seen it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not make an announcement, oh, Ibn Umar claim he seen the hilal, and he has seen it. That's what some imams are doing in England. They said the messenger, anybody seen, I haven't seen it. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sumu li ru'yatihi wa afturu li ru'yatihi, فإن غم عليكم أسر ترقى الحديث رب أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أسد سوم لرؤيته ورفتر لرؤيته فإن غم عليكم ورقي عنكم فأكملوا عدة شعبان 30 fast for visualizations break fast for seeing the next hilal if it's not clear then complete 30 days. Another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Ashhur, haakada watch, haakada, that is 30 days, and he did it again, wa haakada, and then, lada, 29 days. So the months will be 29 or 30 days. Okay? We don't make the months 31 days. Just because we didn't see the hilal, no. That's it. Whether you see it or not. The issue, actually, in my analogy, over this time, that is all about this anti-Saudi attitude. Okay? If you don't like the Saudis, Maghreb or head doesn't matter. It's not it. You do what you like, but Allah Azza wa Jal chose His house to be in Mecca. He chose the Medina, the city of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to be in the Arabian Peninsula. Allah Azza wa Jalla chose that the whole Ummah will gather in one place once a year, and He chose Mecca in the Arabian Peninsula for that. So whether you like the Saudis or don't like the Saudis, do what you like. But you still have you want to do Hajj, you have to go there. And you cannot have your own Arafah, by the way. You have to comply to Arafah. Another hadith. Now what happened? If we doubt, what do we do? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ صَوْمَكُمْ يَوْمَ تَصُومُونَ وَفِطْرَكُمْ يَوْمَ تَفْطُرُونَ وَنُسُكُكُمْ يَوْمَ تُضَحُّونَ Your fasting is the day that you will fast, the day of fasting, and breaking your fast is the day that you all break your fast. And وَيَوْمَ نَحْرِكُمْ يَوْمَ تُضْحَرُونَ another one, or يَوْمَ نُسِبْكُمْ The day of Nahr means the Eid al-Adha is the day that you all do the Nahr. What does that mean? It means actually, even if they got it wrong, even if the Saudis between brackets, got it wrong, okay? But they're fasting, then we fast all together. We fast all together. When Rasulullah says, صوموا لرؤيته, he doesn't say the whole Ummah. Fast for seeing it, all of you, whether you are in England or in America, okay? So, صوموا, صومكم يوم تصومون, they're fasting when you fast, you break fast when you all break fast. Allah will, even if it's a wrong day, Allah will make it for you the right day. Yeah. فمن شاهد وشاهد فلا صوم. نعم. So what happened in the in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, yes, they do calculation for the administrative calendar. But for Nusuk calendar, for Zidane, for Hajj, they have court. And people have to witness. They go by the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, if they got the promise in the Dumas, we follow. Alhamdulillah. And I hope this message that is clear. Anybody have any question? Because what is spoiling actually? We have to, you know, the Messiah Dajjal. He's going to enter into every house. And the Messiah Dajjal come in all sorts. Do you know this hadith about Messiah Dajjal? That actually he started off as a scholar, as a sheikh. Did you know that? He became in the form of sheikh, then a scholar, then become a star scholarly, and slowly, slowly come back. Then the Dajjal start appearing. Then he become a Dajjal because there were stages. He came in so many forms. Did you know Mirza Qasim Qadhani, Ghulam Ahmad Mirza Qadhani? Yeah. Did you know he was a Muslim scholar to start with? And because people gossip up so much, fitna came into him. He failed that fitna, and he made himself to be a prophet. Yeah. And so on. So, follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ignore me. Ignore every Tom, Dick, Harry, Ali, Ahmed, and whatever. Okay. And just follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Messenger of Allah. He said, اتبعوا ولا تتبعوا فقط فيكم. You see? Follow and have a debate in science, in calculation, discrimination. فقط فيكم, you have been surprised. أولا يكفي أننا نزلنا على كتاب. Is it not surprised for the person to do today the book? I'm really sorry if I'm taking longer than what I thought. Yeah. But I hope